हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, संभाजीराव केंद्रे महाविद्यालय जळकोट, डिस्ट्रिक्ट लातूर, महाराष्ट्र। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट द प्रिजर्वेशन ऑफ फूड्स। नाउ इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द फूड पॉइजनिंग और फूडबॉर्न इन्फेक्शंस एंड इंटॉक्सिकेशंस। बिफोर गोइंग फर्दर, डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू, इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते यूट्यूब चैनल, देन डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल सो दैट यू विल गेट नोटिफिकेशंस अबाउट अपकमिंग वीडियोज। एंड ऑल्सो डोंट फॉरगेट टू शेयर कमेंट these videos, share all these videos with your friends so that they will also get benefited. That's why that is very important. So in today's lecture we will see about this very important topic of food microbiology, and that is food poisoning. In that we will see food infections, food intoxications, that we are going to see one by one. So what is this food poisoning? So food poisoning, it is an illness which is caused by the infection with microorganisms and ingestion of toxins produced or by chemical poisoning. So if that foods get contaminated with the different types of pathogenic microorganisms, or if that foods consist of the toxins produced by these pathogenic microorganisms, and if such food is consumed by human being, then it causes the illness. And such illness which is caused after the ingestion of such contaminated foods, that is called as food poisoning. So to occur this food poisoning, there are different causes or reasons. For example, bacteria and their toxins, viruses, chemicals, as well as vegetable poisoning. So these are the causes of occurrence of food poisoning in society or for individual persons. Next one is here, food poisoning or foodborne illness. So those foods which are contaminated with pathogenic microorganisms, usually they do not look bad, taste bad, or they smell bad, because whatever that foods they get contaminated, they looks normal. That means they do not look bad, they do not taste bad, or they do not smell bad. And it is impossible to determine whether a food is contaminated with pathogenic microorganisms without microbiological testing. So we cannot determine whether that food is contaminated with these pathogenic microorganisms or not. So to determine whether that food is contaminated or not, we have to perform the microbiological testing on that particular food sample. So classification of foodborne diseases. So how these foodborne diseases are classified? So these foodborne diseases are classified into two types. One is foodborne infections and second one is foodborne intoxications. So what are these foodborne infections? Foodborne infections are caused by the ingestion of food containing live bacteria which grow and establish themselves in the human intestinal tract. So foodborne infection, it is caused due to the ingestion of foods which consist of live bacteria. Actually here, that is in foodborne infections, that live bacteria are responsible for the illness caused in that particular person who consumes or who consume that food material or that food. So that is called as foodborne infection. It is due to the ingestion of live bacteria. Second one is here, foodborne intoxications. So what are these foodborne intoxications? Foodborne intoxications, these are caused by the ingestion of foods containing toxins which are formed by the bacteria, which resulted from the bacterial growth in the food atom. And here the live microorganisms does not have to be consumed. So in case of foodborne infections, whatever that infections, these are intoxications, whatever that intoxications are caused here, these are due to the ingestion of those foods which consist of toxins produced by the bacteria. In case of foodborne infection, we have seen that foodborne infection, these are caused by the live bacteria. But in case of foodborne intoxication, it is caused due to the ingestion of toxin produced by the pathogens or that bacteria. So we ingest that toxin along with that food material, and then we get suffered from the foodborne infections, intoxications. Okay. So one by one we will see here. The first one is the foodborne infection. So these can either be bacterial, viral, or parasitic. So whatever that foodborne infections are here, these are caused by
bacteria, these are caused by viruses, or these are caused by parasites. In today's lecture, we are going to study about that foodborne infections by bacteria. Okay, so that foodborne infections tend to have long incubation period.
So in case of diseases, that incubation period means here it is the period or time between the entry of that pathogens in the body and appearance of symptoms. So the time between these two events, entry of pathogen inside the body and appearance of symptoms, so that time or that period, it is called as incubation period. And in case of foodborne infections, that incubation period is longer, and generally it is characterized by a fever to that individual. So first we will see bacterial foodborne infections. So bacteria, these are the most troublesome as well as important biological foodborne hazard for the food services and food retail establishment. And these bacterial cells, as we know, they can exist in two different forms. One is the vegetative state, which is a metabolically active form, and another one is the spore state, which is in a dormant state. And this spore state of bacteria, it is metabolically inactive form. That spores, these are produced when the bacterial cells is in an environment where it cannot grow. For example, frozen foods, dried foods, means that bacteria get converted to endospores or spores. But when the environmental conditions are unfavorable, or if there is a deficiency of nutrients, so that bacteria, they convert themselves to another form, dormant form, that is called as spores. So this is one bacteria which is responsible for the foodborne infections, and that is Escherichia coli or E. coli. So this Escherichia coli group of bacteria, it includes four strains of foodborne pathogens, and that four strains of E. coli includes enterotoxigenic E. coli, enteropathogenic E. coli, enterohemorrhagic E. coli, and enteroinvasive E. coli. So the most important of the group is particular type of enterohemorrhagic E. coli, which is called as E. coli 0157H7. And the illness or infection can be due to the infection and a toxico infection. So this illness due to this bacteria or E. coli is particularly serious in case of infants, because it can cause kidney failure and bloody diarrhea. That is in case of infants. So this is the diagram of this E. coli 0157H7, that is the enterohemorrhagic strain of E. coli. Now which foods are involved here? So the microorganisms, the common foods which are involved, and that microorganisms can be isolated from a raw milk and raw ground beef. Transmission in foods, how these E. coli get transferred or transmitted to the foods. So this Escherichia coli is usually transferred to foods like beef by contact with the intestine of animals. And that transmission can also occur if that employees are carriers. Carriers means here, so that person or that employees, they harbors this pathogenic bacteria, that is E. coli, but they does not show any symptom. Then we can say that person or that employee is a carrier for that Escherichia coli or for that particular bacteria. And if they do not wash their hands properly after going to the bathroom, so in this case, that employee who is a carrier, it can transmit this pathogen to the foods. So that foods get contaminated. So how to prevent this foodborne infection, which is caused by the enterohemorrhagic E. coli? So this prevention includes cooking of hamburger patties until well done or until all the juices run clear. Then do not use raw milk products. So that should be properly preserved or that should be properly cooked. Then make sure that employees practices good personal hygiene. So that is very important preventive measures to prevent the that foodborne infections caused by enterohemorrhagic Escherichia coli. Then second bacteria or foodborne infection is Salmonella, or which is caused by the Salmonella species. So this Salmonella, it is a facultative anaerobic bacterium and that frequently causes a foodborne infection. And like that of Escherichia coli, the source of Salmonella is the intestinal tracts of warm-blooded animals. Common foods which are involved in foodborne infection caused by Salmonella species includes that raw meat and poultry products, eggs, milk, dairy products, pork, milk chocolate, and cream-filled desserts. So these are the foods or common foods which are involved in the foodborne infection caused by Salmonella species. So this is the diagram of the Salmonella bacteria here, which are the rod-shaped bacteria. So how these bacteria get transmitted in the foods? So that transmission to foods is very common by cross-contamination from raw foods and especially from the poultry. And from food contact surfaces, for example cutting boards or from food handlers, these pathogenic bacteria, that is Salmonella, get transmitted to the foods. So how to prevent the transmission of this salmonellosis or salmonella pathogen? So cook foods thoroughly, practices good personal hygiene, then clean and sanitize food contact surfaces after used with raw foods. So these are the preventive measures for the prevention of foodborne infection caused by Salmonella species. Next one is here, Shigella species. So Shigella, it is a facultative anaerobic bacterium that causes about 10% of foodborne illnesses in the United States. And the infection which is caused by Shigella, it is called as Shigellosis. The microorganisms, these are frequently found in the intestines of humans and other warm-blooded animals. So that microorganisms, it can cause infection or it can cause toxicoinfection. And the common illness which is caused by this Shigella, it is called as bacillary dysentery. Now the common foods which are involved here, this includes generally ready to eat salads, for example potato, chicken, milk and dairy products, poultry and raw vegetables. Transmission, how that foods get contaminated here? So water that is contaminated by fecal materials and unsanitary handling by food workers, these are the common transmission routes of contamination of foods by these Shigella species. And how it is prevented? So the prevention includes practicing good personal hygiene and washing of foods with potable water supply, or that is what that water which is suitable for drinking purposes also. So if we practices these preventive measures, then we are able to prevent the foodborne infection which is caused by Shigella species. Next one is here, Campylobacter jejuni. So this Campylobacter jejuni, it is considered by many food scientists as the number one agent that causes foodborne illness. And these microorganisms which causes infection, it is unique as compared to most other foodborne pathogens because it has a very strict gaseous requirement for growth. And it is classified as a microaerophile because it can tolerate only 3 to 6% oxygen for the growth. So this is the diagram of this Campylobacter jejuni. Then common foods which are involved in this infection includes raw milk and in raw chicken. And there are some scientists who estimate that Campylobacter jejuni may present in nearly 100% of the retail chickens. Now how these get transmitted to the foods? So this Campylobacter jejuni, it is transferred from raw meats to other foods by cross contamination, and this is typically done by the transfer from a food contact surface such as cutting board or from food workers' hands. So these are the main reasons for contamination of foods by this Campylobacter jejuni. So how it is infection by this Campylobacter jejuni can be prevented? So preventive measures includes cooking of raw meats properly, do not use raw milk, that is unpasteurized milk, and thoroughly clean food contact surfaces, that is cutting boards, as well as hands after handling of raw foods. So these are the preventive measures to prevent the foodborne infection which is caused by Campylobacter jejuni. Next one is here, Listeria monocytogenes. So this Listeria monocytogenes is a facultative anaerobic bacterium that causes foodborne infection. And listeriosis, it is the illness caused by Listeria monocytogenes. Usually it causes the gastrointestinal symptoms for the healthy adult. This is the diagram of this Listeria monocytogenes. Then however, that disease complications can be life threatening. For example, it includes septicemia, meningitis, encephalitis, and these are specifically for the people who have weakened immune systems. So it is very important to food retail operations because it can survive under many conditions such as high salt foods, and unlike many other foodborne pathogens, it can grow at refrigerated temperatures, that is below or 41 Fahrenheit degree Celsius or near about that 5 degree Celsius. The common foods which are involved in this Listeria monocytogenes infection includes, that is many foods, and most common in it is common in raw meats, raw poultry, dairy products such as cheeses, ice cream, raw milk, then raw vegetables and seafood. Transmission in foods, how it is expressed? So that transmission to the foods, it can occur by cross contamination, and also that foods which are not cooked properly, they can contain these live cells of these Listeria monocytogenes. So the how it is prevented? So the prevention measures includes cooking of foods thoroughly or properly and practicing of good personal hygiene. So these are the preventive measures with the help of which we can prevent the infection of Listeria monocytogenes. So this was about the bacterial food infections. Now later on we will see the next point is here, that is about the foodborne intoxications. So the next point we will see, that is bacterial foodborne intoxication. So this bacterial foodborne intoxications we will see in another lecture. So friends, if you have not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this YouTube channel so that you will get notifications of upcoming videos. Thank you.